Hey everybody, how's it going? Right now we are doing our Batman number 23 review by DC Comics, the New 52, written by Scott Snyder and art by Greg Capullo. Breakdown. 0 year continues here and Bruce Wayne finds himself in a whole lot of trouble with the Red Hood gang. This issue picks up right where we left off in issue number 22. Bruce Wayne is still, he isn't Batman yet, and really, he doesn't really deserve to be. And the Red Hood gang have the upper hand, and Bruce's life is being threatened. Bruce Wayne gets beat down with a mace, he gets jumped, and he's shot twice. Bruce is taking quite a beating and suffers from more injuries than I've ever seen him face before. He fights for his life in this issue, literally, against the Red Hood gang, as well as try to make it out of a burning building with 2 gunshot wounds. While all of this is going on around him, he seems to go in and out between reality and past memories, thinking constantly of his parents. We also get to see Edward Nygma again in this issue, and apparently he doesn't see eye to eye with Bruce's uncle, Philip. Philip doesn't agree with the way Edward is handling things, so he tries to take matters into his own hands and get control of things. For whatever reason, there's like this big magnet underneath the floor of the server room that's activated with a secret password by Nygma, a password that he isn't supposed to know. It takes Bruce's uncle by surprise, and he's brought immediately to the ground by a gun in his hand and a metal plate in his head. Edward is disappointed by the lack of cooperation by Philip, and he resigns from Wayne Enterprises as their computer strategist. Bruce finally makes his way back to the mansion where Alfred is there to patch him up. After Alfred is done, Bruce goes into another wing of the mansion to reflect and ponder on the most recent events. While pondering, though, Bruce asks his father to show him what to do, and a bat finds its way into the mansion, and this is when Bruce gets the idea of becoming the Batman. In conclusion, this book was okay. It was an average issue at best. There was a decent amount of dialogue on 2 to 3 pages in the middle of the book. Other than that, there really was not a lot of dialogue throughout the rest of the issue. I read through it rather quickly. The artwork by Greg Capullo, as always, is top-notch. I think this book is worth reading if you can come to yourself to not purchase it. Maybe borrow it from a friend, or just kind of read through it at your local comic shop or newsstand. My rating for Batman issue number 23 is a 3 out of 5. Read the issue. You guys tell me what you think. Thanks for joining us.